probably thought I'm sitting in my home theater, but it's not the home theater or not a private cinema. This is the Lenovo Yoga Tab Pro 2. It's got a projection with it. We'll see what all it has.
Hi folks, today we have the Lenovo Yoga Tablet 2 Pro with us. It's a 13.3 inches tablet, you know, like a complete laptop. It's 13.3 inches and comes with Android and a lot more. You'll see what I mean by a lot more. So if I go by the specification, it's got Intel Z37454 core, 1.86 GHz processor in it, a 13.3 inches of display, which is a QHD display with a resolution of 2560 into 1440 IPS. And the system memory includes 2GB, that is 21GB LDDR3 64-bit RAM. The system capacity for the storage is 32GB eMMC. And it supports the LAN standards for 802.11abgn+bt 4.0, that is Bluetooth 4.0 support. Then it's the Android OS 4.4 in it, and the battery is, as you can see, 3.75 volts, 36 wh. So it's a portable tablet computer, the Yoga Tablet 2 Pro, and it comes in platinum color. It's got a lot of goodies with it, which I'll show it to you once we open the box. So if you open the box, you will see how huge it is, first of all. So you can see the size of this. It's almost bigger than the MacBook Air over here. So you can see it's QHD display, a projector inside. That's what the surprise was. Projector, 2.1 surround sound, JBL speakers, and as it's a yoga tablet, it supports all the multi-modes supported by the earlier versions of tablets of yoga. The Yoga 8 inches, if you've viewed it or seen it. So let's switch on the display. And crisp QHD display, huge display, I would say. And that's the camera thing. So as it's a Yoga Tablet 2 Pro, it supports all the multi-modes. You can hold it, you can put it in stand, you can put it as a keyboard, you can hang it. So again, if we talk about the hardware of this device, you can see 2.1 Dolby Surround speaker. This is the front speaker, and at the back there is the other JBL speaker. So it's 2.1 surround sound, two speakers in the front, one at the back, then the camera. And this is the biggest and the best thing about this, the projector. And the projector is here, the Beacon projector, and this is focus projector. So like in the early version, which the 8.8 inches of Lenovo Yoga tablet, you just pull out the hinge and start hanging it. This one has got a button, which you just press the button, pops out. So you now can, you know, adjust the stand as per you need. You can make it stand, you can, you know, pull it out completely and start using it while hanging it. You can just simply hang it and, you know, do a lot of other things with the Yoga stand. We've already shown it in the other tablet review, what all you can do with the stand. So coming back to the Yoga Tablet 2 Pro, again, the back you'll find concealed SIM card and memory card extension, where the ports are, so you can extend your memory and put a new SIM, so it supports 3G. And this is the camera, the new camera. Just pop out the stand, let's move this. On the other side, it's similar circular hinge, and you'll see the power button, which is button, and this has a light with it, so when you put it on charging, this glows white and it keeps glowing and it shows that the product is being charged. And this is the 3.5mm audio jack. Apart from that, is the USB standard micro USB charger, the volume rocker over here. On the other side, you'll just see the sleek big button. On the other side, you'll see the projector and the projection button. You can just see with the projection icon over here and the projection button, and there's a mic over here. So we'll demo the projection part of the device already. So we have demoed the projection part of the device in the intro of the video. We'll show what else you can do with the projection part. So if I open the projection app, you can see cinema, pictures, documents, and story. So if I click on cinema, you'll see a video. You can also plug in your own pen drive using the USB OTG and watch any movie you want to, and then come with pictures. You can see what all pictures it has, and then you can just pull it on the large screen. And if you go to documents, you can click on any of the documents, like for the video, and it will ask if you want to project. So you can just simply project it. If I keep on, no, it will not. And then you have Story. So Story is a software by Lenovo where you can build stories with your pictures, and it says, do you want to switch on projections? If I click on yes, the projection starts, and you can see the projection has started, and I can project it on any surface and it will start projecting it. See, and I can adjust the focus if I think it's not coming the way it should be. I can sharpen it up, I can, you know, move it around, show you the demo. So I can adjust on the sharpness of the screen size numbers. As with projection, the further I move, the bigger the screen gets. So you can see, it's that easy. So you can project anything through the projection app, be it pictures, stories, slideshows, or your movies, or whatever it is. You can just open it to the projection app and start projecting it. So I can right now, you know, close the projection. I click on stop projection and get back to the tablet. So as I've mentioned, it's a huge 13.3 inches tablet, so I put it on stand and show it. So this is if I want to type, so I can just open to this stand mode and start typing. It's very easy to type like that. This is like normal lock hinge, and again, as you have the cylindrical design, it's very easy and it is a comfort for you when you're typing. With palm support, it really helps you. So if I click on this, I can start typing very comfortably. I can click on email and it give me the keyboard. So you can see a huge keyboard, in fact much bigger than a normal laptop, and you can just start typing here. If I drop the blog over here, so you can see the typewriter sound, which is fun to type on. And then a lot of other things that Lenovo always gives you, the goodies that Lenovo comes along with the Lenovo device. You can see Security HD, which is a security suit by Lenovo for you. You can just click on it to speed up the RAM, and you can see HD. So Security HD has the option to speed it up, the ad blocker, the app manager, and it shows the internal memory, and there's no SD card installed. So ample amount of memory here, you can see. Still have around 25 GB remaining for the internal storage, and 148 apps are installed. 13 apps can be moved to the SD card, and 22 apps installed. It's just suggesting that apps are done. Then, if I go to this permissions, it's like privacy setting. You can select the apps that send SMS or calls or whatever, so you can control what app gets what privileges. So, really great suite over here. And then I go to SyncKit HD. If you know about SyncKit by Lenovo, it's one of the best apps out there for any platform, and you know, for any Android device over there. So you can just keep your stuff here and sync it to the cloud, and whenever you want it, you can just get it back from there. So you don't need to really go crazy on your internal storage. You can store all your HD things on your cloud server and then retrieve it when you need it. So Share It and Clone It, these are two apps that I've been using and, you know, preaching about for transferring my data across Android devices. As a reviewer, I have to change my devices quite often, and Share It and Clone It really helps me. So when I click on Share It, I can share any content from my device to a phone or a tablet, and it's very simple. I just need to just transfer it, and it just click on start and starts transferring and select my name and everything. So, and the other thing is Clone It. It's for somebody like me or any other tech reviewer. When you're switching your Android devices, you know one key to import all apps, contacts, SMS, photo, etc. from old device to new device without using data. So that's incredible. You don't use your Wi-Fi, you don't use your 3G, it just does it for you. And it's super quick, so you don't need to worry about how much time would it take to transfer completely. So then the next app you'll see is Dolby here. So with the Dolby app, you can change modes to movie, music, games, voice, custom. You can set your own equalizers, your surround virtualization, your digital enhancements, and you will see the equalizer right here. So you can play around with these, and it's quite fun to, you know, check the audio quality once you change your EQ. So when you select a movie, it is enhanced by Dolby for movie quality. It's intelligent IQ with sound, focus sound, so whatever sound you need. When you do it, open sound, when you're in an open place, you want bridge sound, you want focus, compact sound. So everything is there. So you can switch on or off the Dolby app. So let's go back and see. So you've seen the projection app, the security HD app, sync HD app, share it, clone it, Dolby. Rest is the email. This is the Lenovo eFrame app, which is great for a tablet like this, where you can, you know, open it and you can click on this photo, and you know, you can use it as a frame where you hang the tablet. So in the hang mode, you can just use it as a frame and it'll stay on. So the eFrame app does that for you. And then the video player, settings, file browser, calendar, clock, calculator, the usual apps, user guide to help you around the tablet, which is an intelligent move because, you know, there are a lot of things like basics and other things that you don't know about the device and you just want to learn how to go about it. So for example, this is how you get the control center in a Lenovo Android app. So for a regular Android user, you would keep scrolling from the top and seeing what is there. So you can just scroll from bottom, select on your advanced controls like Wi-Fi, GPS, sleep, rotate, Dolby, projection, multi-view, airplane mode and Bluetooth. And you can access the camera, lock screen, screenshot from right here, Lenovo smart switch, settings, auto brightness, everything from the control center. So you can just play around with it from the control center itself and pull it down. So if I move to camera, I want to learn the basics of camera. So it'll tell me how to take the camera, what all mode it has, what network. That's a good thing because users usually want to know, and most of the queries get solved inside this app itself. So then I move on to the next app, that is the Lenovo Sketchpad. And it's not something that you will see a sketchpad like a paint and you can draw it. You can draw on any screen. You can just pick up whatever you need, whatever tool you need, whatever color you want. So if I pick it up and I write something on this, so I can start writing on anything, any surface, any screen I am on, and I can just, you know, send it as a screenshot or just delete it right away. So I can just click on OK and move it. So it's like active pick, note taking on any screen you want. So this is like the demo app. You've got Apple 2.4, what all features it has. So if I want to see what is inside the Yoga Tab 2 Pro, you can see what all modes it has and everything. So the projection thing. So you can project on any surface, if it's a flat surface. I can click on projector demo. Projector demo will start. Keep it on any surface, click on the projector, and it will start watching. You just need a flat surface and you can start watching. Light, preferably. So any screen is your home screen, like a home theater for you. You can just have your own private theater, and that's lovely about it. I don't know how people are living without it, because you know, for time I've been reviewing it, it's become an integral part of my life. I've been using it almost daily to watch my favorite soaps and series on TV, and you know, I use it at work for showcasing some DVDs. It's been amazing. So that's like the product demo app, then the Google Maps and the YouTube and Chrome apps, and then the navigation app that has been provided in the Navigation 66 view. And there are some bundled apps like Kingston Office, Amazon Kindle, Game Store from the Lenovo Game Store, and then Evernote exactly. For communication, we have Booster, Skype, for social. So these apps are pre-installed, you can start just your tablet and start using them. This is the home screen where you have the weather and also, you know, whatever widget you want to have. So you can change the widget if you don't need it, print to your widgets. So I can select what all widget I need. So I can change it with that. If I, for example, you know, I want to change this one. I click on close and close. And I want to add Dolby Digital Plus for it. I'll just pick it up and put Dolby Digital Plus on it. Or I can even use this one for Dolby and remove this one. So whatever widget I need, I can just add it over here. I use the calculator, calendar for that. It's a little bigger for the screen. So I use this size. It shows any events I have, active widgets. I can, for instance, use email. all my emails and I have to set up like so very customizable home screen. You know, the control center, easy control, the notifications, all accessible. So really intelligent UI, as I've always praised Lenovo Yoga UI. So let's go to the specification or the detailing of the OS and see what all it has. So let's go to settings, and you can see in settings the usual settings, but it's a very clean interface, white and colorful icons over here. So for projection you have display enhancements and orientation, projector on off tip. And if I go to about the device, so I'll see it's running Android 4.4.2. The model number is Yoga Tablet 2 Pro 138F, and the kernel version, the build number, software. If I click on CPU RAM, we already discussed it, it's 32GB capacity, 2GB RAM and 4 core 1.8 GHz processor powered by Intel. And then if I go to Lenovo Smart Switch, it says manual or automatic auto. The settings for multi-window, which is using the multitasking opportunity in the app. So go there, I can open app side by side. This is for closing all the running apps and clear that much more RAM. So very easy interface, and for multi-window I can open maybe calculator and maybe Chrome and maybe file browser. So you can see how many apps I've opened. It's like, you know, using Windows, you have minimizes and you can increase the size, lower the size. So I can play around with what tab I want on top and what if I want to calculate quickly something and then put the figures there. So really great multitasking over there. So next thing what I'll demo is if I want to use, you know, my own personal movie collection and want to project it on a large screen, so how to go about it. So that's very simple, I'll show you how to do it. So if I want to see some movies of my own collection and I want to project it through the Lenovo Yoga Tablet 2 Pro, so I just need to have a USB OTG cable and a pen drive attached to it. So what I'll do is put the OTG cable in the port here, the micro USB port. Simply plug that in inside. And once it's plugged in, you'll see that it detects it automatically and the file browser opens. So that now the pen drive is connected, the file browser is going to external storage, I can see the movies. So if I play it from here, like right now, what will happen is it will start playing directly to a video player. And as I want to project it, what I'll go to cinema and I can see all the movies that were in the pen drive on here. So let's like try escape plan. And I want to say yes, I want to have projection to it. So the projection is started for the movie. You can see it on the screen also, but also on the projector. So I'll just forward it a bit.
It's a lie. It's state of the art. The only problem is it's located next to that secure fire garage.
The projection of the movie.
First, I needed to get inside, so I made some enemies. Inside, it was obvious you were short-staffed. Not on guidelines, but
it's just playing on a regular surface right now.
You only use one. Knowing the guards routine was the next step.
I switch off the light to make it
better.
You can see what I'm now doing is I think the light, I have to focus it a bit.
After I knew the routine, all I had to do was pick the day. And arrange for a distraction at the front gate. You park exactly
the side, increase the size, whatever I want
to
do.
Box to get out.
And then it does the focus.
You have very good chocolate milk. See, the cards contain a thin layer of wax laminate.
So that's actually playing on a flat surface. That's what I had to do.
The keypad, the impression will indicate which four keys are
just played on any surface. Should be just flat surface, preferably white to give you a better quality. So I'll just close the projection. You can see how you can create your own cinema and enjoy movies just by attaching a pen drive to your favorite collection and start playing the movies. So that's it about the Lenovo Yoga Tablet 2 Pro, and I am telling you, this is the tablet for not just for professionals, because it looks like a professional tablet because it's called Pro and it's 13.3 inches, but for home entertainment this is the thing.